Silent, but a moment of silence for Cecily, who sits suffering in a hot cell right now while we're here on these hot steps. Just one moment of silence, please. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm here today to stand in solidarity with the family and friends of Cecily McMillan, who I recently learned is a resident of the 36th District, which means that she's my constituent. A few years ago, when Occupy took place, I had the pleasure of participating in the writing of the resolution that called for support from the City Council for those members exercising their constitutional rights. And I was proud that day as we set a tone, as we set a tone here at City Council. So look where we're standing today, on the steps of City Hall. Our right to gather here and speak out to express our opinions, whatever they may be, is enshrined in the First Amendment of the Constitution. The freedom we have to assemble in a public square and protest distinguishes our system of government from many other around the world. These rights are precious, and they're worth being protected passionately. And very often, it is government's response to protests that rivets public attention and demonstrates the imbalance that is being protested. The current case against Cecily arose in the context of a unique protest movement known as Occupy Wall Street. The movement was a protest against the extreme and growing inequities in wages and in our justice system. The protests were massive. They were creative, and they were extremely effective in giving voice to frustrations experienced by millions during the economic downturn and since. That change in our consciousness would not have happened if Occupy protesters like Cecily had not put their bodies on the line, sacrificing their physical comfort and risking their safety and their liberty. I respect the risks the Occupy protesters took. They were meaningful, and they have led to change. Particular attention our city is now paying to the needs of the 99%. To me, it's only fair to consider this context in sentencing Cecily. The majority of the jurors who sat and heard all the facts of the case believe she deserves leniency, and I do too. And I believe if the judge gives the proper weight to the context that led to her arrest, Ms. McMillan will be sentenced to community service and allowed to return to my district to continue to raise her voice in support of the needs and the rights of the masses. I join you in calling today for extreme leniency in this case. Thank you.